And sometimes see in the
speaker.
All right. Any idea? Let me see. How many people have joined? Any idea? Ronak, any idea how many have joined?
86.
500 are supposed to join.
It is showing 86.
86. All right, that's fine. We'll go ahead. Maybe taking time, but it's already 3 o'clock. So the first thing, and I hope sometimes we can make mind frame bigger, Ronak, whenever I'm making action, because there is a how to become a speaker. So the screen in which I am being seen, that also can be made bigger sometimes. That will be great. So how to become speaker? RamMohan Bhave, of course, you know my name, and my number is 9167446744. When I put this first slide, and I'm deliberately getting into a chat mode, I'm asking you, what is that which comes to your mind immediately? What is that which attracts your attention immediately? Any idea? What is that you can see here? You find something which you want to talk about this slide? You want to talk about something on this slide? Yeah, anybody please?
Numbers.
Quickly write in chat mode. Quickly write in chat mode. What do you want to write? What is something? Even after 5-10 minutes, you will remember about this slide. Okay. Why this is done? Because you see, any speaker wants to have the audience to center their attention on something. So obviously, this error of spelling has been deliberately done. Obviously, you can imagine that person who is a CA generally don't make a mistake of writing the word become. Okay. Unless he has become a 21st century generation youngster, he is now compressing everybody into the spellings. All right, fine. So this is the first tip for you. And in the very first slide, you should force something others to think of it. Now I see the next speech you remember from any Hindi movie. When you discuss speeches, so could you tell me which is that speech which you remember from any Hindu movie which you have seen? कौन सा ऐसा speech है तो हम लोगों ने काफी सुना है, काफी याद रहता है? Right? Any speech you think of? Any effective speech? Any speech where people were like impressed or you feel, that's a great speech.
Can I speak? Hello?
I'm listening in the yes. Chat.
Yes, speak. This is Divya here, and I think...
Don't speak, please. Put on mute.
Okay.
Write whatever you want to write. Write on chat mode. So you're already seeing 4-5 replies. Now start voting for whichever you feel is the most impactful.
Idiot's spelling guy, ID.
Keep on mute. All right. as you are going to deliver a speech, which one of the speech you would like to be giving, like? The question is pretty close. So, and I would of course put it the speech which I like. And this always inspires me. Okay. And I can see many of you voting for Chak De India. And that Shah Rukh Khan speech, ye saptar minute and like that. So how many times we are able to say ye saptar minute? Now, the purpose of this is, why I am asking this question. One, it is related to the content of the speech. And second, generally speaking, we are a speaker should start with a sentence which normally everybody will agree. Okay. So even if you start with a subject that how many of you like chocolates or how many of you like ice creams, okay? So generally everybody will say yes. So you create some kind of a positive energy among the audience. That is the secret of one of the good speakers which I have read, heard, practiced. And it may happen that some naughty guys will show disagreement. Don't bother, simply ignore them. Because when majority is on your side, no need to listen to minority. Okay. So here is RamMohan Bhave, Chartered Accountant, Cost Accountant, Company Secretary, Lekha Record Holder. 1800 lectures talking to you. 100 lectures in last 9 years. Students in 30 countries. 125 graduation lectures, etc. But 41,000 Facebook friends, 81,000 LinkedIn. So therefore,
what the kami hota?
All right. Shruta Shulabha. There is a Sanskrit proverb. Sanskrit proverb says that Shruta Tatra Durlabha. Shruta means audience. Shruta means audience. Now, Tatra means and Durlabha means very difficult. So the Sanskrit proverb says that getting an audience is the most difficult thing. Okay. Vakta Dasha Sahasreshu Shruta Tatra Durlabha. Now, why getting an audience is very difficult? Why getting an audience is very difficult? Okay. So, getting an audience is difficult because there are no great speakers. We have heard in history, Napoleon and Hitler, how good their philosophies were is a different thing. But they used to be so great speakers that the people were getting charged up by them and the soldiers were ready to even die for them. So that is the power of a speaker. We find it very pathetic speakers. So let us solve this problem in the room. And that is why today's session I am holding. In order that all of us can share, because in my life, I might have given thousands of speeches. In last 9 years, 1800. And on an average, maybe I have crossed 10,000. Next, our today's speaker does not need introduction. You go for a seminar and the person who comes for introduction says that our today's speaker is so popular that he does not need introduction at all. But the introduction karne wala aadmi, the person comes in, however, brings a paper in his hand and he starts reading it, which is very funny. Because if he is so much popular, why do you need to read? Why do you need to read? Okay. So there is no need to read. Then you should be able to talk. What do you call? Impromptu. So most of the speeches start with the introduction of the speaker. And that is so boring. The fellow may be very popular, but we are making a mess of it. So the most important thing we should talk about is your chat should be impromptu. If we are feeling that I do not know the word impromptu, then let us understand one thing. What is meant by impromptu? Impromptu means whisper of a moment, without any preparation, without much preparation. What are the challenges involved to speak impromptu? One, I may have stage fear. Second, I may not be strong at content. And third, that I may be not confident about language, like English, for example. Now, how to solve this problem? First of all, when it comes to content, we should be well prepared in advance, or we should learn from the points which we have read about. Let me give an example. Somebody, a young boy, came to me and he said, I want to give a speech. How do I learn giving speeches? I said, tell me, you were told to write essays. For example, the essay could be leader. Therefore,
आवाजाचं व्हॉल्यूम अतिशय कमी आहे सर.
सर, देयर इज लॉट ऑफ डिस्टर्बन्स.
बट डिस्टर्बन्स इज नॉट क्लियर. सो रौनक, कॅन यू हॅव अ लुक ॲट इट?
आपका ऑडियो में बहुत सारा इको आ रहा है और आपका कैमरा भी थोड़ा पीछे ले लीजिए, लॉन्ग शॉट रखिए आपका, बस ऐसे थोड़ा ऊंचा कर, थोड़ा ऊपर कर, प्लीज पीछे जा रहा है. हाँ, और आपका ऊपर का ज्यादा दिख रहा है, आपका फेस कम दिख रहा है. हाँ, बस ऐसे ऐसे एग्जैक्टली बराबर है. लेकिन अभी ऑडियो का प्रॉब्लम ये है सर, माइक आपके पास रखिए बिल्कुल, क्योंकि इको बहुत आ रहा है.
Can you hear me now? Can you hear me now?
Yes, very clear.
Yes, yes.
Hello. So what I was saying was, one is content. Now, how we were told to speak on my favorite leader, or so I tell them, okay, what do you like? So if he's a Gujarati guy, he says, I like phapda and jalebi. I said, give a lecture on phapda and jalebi. Now he gave an excellent speech, which is a very interesting thing. Why? Because that is the topic which he likes. Or if you tell me to speak, I will speak on vada pav, an excellent speech. Where do you get vada pav and how do you get the vada pav, etc. Right. Then we come to, apart from content, we come to a situation of confidence. Now, confidence comes by practice. And the third thing is that English as a language. You know, many of us want to speak in English, but we lose the confidence. The only way to go about it is practice yourself. And I'll recommend you to hear the autobiography of Demosthenes in order to know about it. So one simple tip, do not read speech. It is better to speak for 3 minutes than reading for 10 minutes. It's better to speak for 3 minutes, because if you read by keeping the papers in front of you, people start murmuring among themselves, if we were to call for this speech, why not if better it email it to us, and it becomes a mockery. And I have seen this happening to the very, very top speakers. The next thing is, try to know your audience in advance. It can make a huge difference. For example, if we are going to give a speech to the engineers, don't go with advanced concept in finance. Or if you are going to give a lecture to the chartered accountants or cost accountants or company secretaries, don't go with the engineering expertise of yours. Then find the age group. You know, sometimes you teach in corporate, sometimes you teach in school students or college students, and sometimes you talk about young professionals. Every time our approach should be different. So knowing who is the audience, the number of audience, then their seniority, their age group, their qualification, knowing that in advance is very, very important. Autobiography of Demosthenes. I'll spell it here, Divya. Demosthenes. Okay. I'll tell you some part from his autobiography also. So age group, qualification, experience and seniority. These things you must know. Then, one of the biggest success one can get in his speech is humor is a must. If you have a humor, then obviously. Now the humor can be in yourself, very carefully on the audience itself. Or the best way to do the humor is on a general subjects. Like, what do I say? Now today, of course, we are in a corona atmosphere, so any humor could be creating tensions. But I mean, you can always have the humors on the normal subjects, okay? Of politics, for example, okay, how politicians are serving this country. Everybody will laugh at it. Then create anxiety. You know, I'll tell you something. You know, in my corporate career, in the very first year, I got very big challenges. And when I got very big challenges, I came across one personality who actually gave me the tips which were the most important tips in my life. And I remember even after 40 years. Would you like to hear about those tips? And would you like to know how the whole life changed for me? If yes, please type yes in the chat mode. Quick, because I'm finding very few yes. There's a big number who is talking about yes, yes. Did you see anybody saying no? You are not seeing anybody saying no. The question is there any answer to this question? No. I created an anxiety among you to know about something. So really speaking, there is no such person. One person who created any great impact 50 years back and I still remember it. No. But I just wanted to create anxiety among you. Yeah, there is something this speaker is going to tell us. Something to tell. But creating anxiety isn't. So you should have a content which arouses the interest. You know, somebody said that is why we are here, etc. Then some other funny types of people you come across. You know, what are those people? They read slides. Okay? They read slides. How do they read slides? They are looking at their laptop or they are looking at the screen. Now, if you are looking at the screen and speaking, then when will you look at the audience? You are not looking at the audience at all. Biggest cardinal mistake. So you should not look at the slides at all. Now the question comes, then how do you look at the slides or how do you remember what you are speaking? In that case, you should see on your laptop, which is in your front, but don't read from there because you should have written only bullet points. What is PowerPoint? Should you have PowerPoint every time? Answer is yes. You must have PowerPoint. That ensures that you organize your speech very well. But don't read slides. If you are reading slides, that is a cardinal mistake. In fact, one of the places where I had gone to hear a speech, the speaker was reading the slides. So somebody after some time got tired and he said, sir, can you give us those slides itself? Then we don't have to take the pains of speaking. So imagine whenever you are reading the slide, you're doing a big mistake. There are 2-3 points in each slide, 5 points maximum. Pick up 1 or 2 points, explain them. Explain them with an example. So reading slides, big no, no, no. Then don't create boring slides. You know, I always tell everybody, what is PowerPoint? PowerPoint is points made powerfully. Whereas our habit is, first find the content of the subject. After you find the content of the subject from Google, take those full sentences, copy paste into the PowerPoint, and there are full sentences, and give that as a PowerPoint. Big mistake. You are not making points, that is not PowerPoint. Then you rather write an essay and circulate to everyone. So what should be done? If we at all have full sentences copied, pasted from Google, copy paste them in a Word file. Then read that whole content. And then keep aside the content and try to create the slides based on what you can remember. If you are creating the slide based on you can remember, then audience will remember your points. And therefore, if audience can remember your points, then audience will remember you. And if audience remembers you, then definitely you will be a good speaker. For example, what comes to my mind right now? Today, a lot of audience will remember me saying, oh no, the audio arrangement was so hopeless. Sir has made a mess of it. Yes, certainly, I'm sorry for that. So I learned from this again. What should have been done? All right. What is a simple test of bad slides? If your slides have a material where there is a full stop somewhere, it means these are not points, these are full sentences, and therefore it is not PowerPoint, it is Word file. Next point, it contains sentences. For example, nobody should talk impromptu sentences while impromptu. Nobody should read from the slide. That is a good practice of speech. If I write like that, what will happen? There will be a long sentence. Then I cannot put it into bigger fonts. And with the result, what happens? The point goes into the next line. I put a full stop. There is a sentence. And while reading, the speaker is also reading at the slide. And the audience doesn't know, should they look at the speaker or should they look at the slide? So finally, what they start doing is they also start reading along with the speaker. And then this is called a Janaganamana. When many people together are reading the slide, I call that as a Janaganamana. So full sentence in a slide, a long sentence in a slide, absolutely disaster. And particularly, you know, when I was teaching a lot of MBAs in nursing and my colleagues were a lot of CAs, I used to find a phenomenal difference. Remember, what is the PowerPoint? What is the bullet point? Minimum words to convey maximum meaning. Okay. So I have made a statement called 5x5. Whenever I make PowerPoint slide, maximum 5 bullets, and none of the bullets should have more than 5 words. Can you hear me? None of the bullets should have more than 5 words. Milind, I hope you can read it. You can hear me. Am I right? Are you able to hear me? And next. I hope you are able to hear me. So the simple test of bad slide is, when you put your slide, go to the 4th or 5th row and see, are you able to read it? You will find that wherever there are a lot of design or long sentences, you cannot read it. And any slide which cannot be read by the audience, then it is a big, horrible issue, because it's a big failure, because your PowerPoint slides or your slides are a waste. Especially in a vertical hall, you have to be very careful. Vertical hall, if there are no televisions to show your slides at the end, please go ahead and request the organizers. So it is good to take test yourself. Whenever your lecture is there, go 5 minutes in advance, find out whether you can read that slides from the. Then another outdated concept, dais. So people like to stand behind the dais. So these things have been completely outdated. The good speakers never go behind dais. The theory currently say that if you are behind dais, you are creating some wall between you and audience. And then you don't become informal, and hence you end up in creating a distance, a wall, and you are trying to show that you are somebody very big, whereas the audience is somebody who is very ignorant. Those days are gone. Nobody is ignorant. It's only that you have one specialized area and they have some other specialized area. They have come to hear you, maybe for what purpose, I don't know, CPA or so, whatever. So dais is outdated concept. Okay. Now, even if you are forced to speak on a dais or stand on the dais, and dais is on a higher height, just get down from the dais and walk in audience. But the dais is so big, or the height of the dais is so big, that you cannot get down. Still, don't remain behind the dais. Come in front of the tables where other people are sitting and start talking informally. And move your eyesight from this end of the audience to that end of the audience. Whatever points I'm telling you, when you attend anybody's next lecture, please have a look and point out yourself in your mind. Virtually, I would say carry out an audit of it. Is this fellow standing behind dais? Is he reading the slides? Is he reading somebody's introduction? Is he reading even vote of thanks? Even, you know, whenever somebody starts a lecture, I'm seeing you even in the conferences which happen. The speaker comes, who has been given 20 minutes. Now, this is another funny thing, actually. We call a speaker, then we find that there are too many speakers. So then we say, okay, instead of speaker, we'll make a panel. So we'll make panel with 60 minutes. By the time that slot comes, the 60 minutes have been time overshot in the previous slot. So 60 minutes have come down to 40 minutes. And then the two or three speakers get 13 to 15 minutes. And if your previous speaker has already overshot, then you get 15 to 20 minutes only. And when you get 15 to 20 minutes only, that time what happens is, you start with saying, Honorable Mr. X, Honorable Mr. Y, and the President of so-and-so, and the Vice President of so-and-so, and past President so-and-so, and Honorable Council members. So another 3 minutes are going into respecting the people on the dais, and finally talking about thanking the audience. Waste of time. Just start informally saying, hello friends. Enough. Okay. There is no need for, especially when you are session second, third. And if there are any special chief guests, maybe you can take one name. Then you should also keep your audience happy. For example, Lias means podium. Yes, yes, podium. I think you are right. I need to correct. I mean podium. All right. So podium, thanks to my friend from Nasik. So give clap to somebody. So I'm giving a clap to Nitin Brahma for pointing out a proper point which I can improve in my presentation next. Thanks, Nitin. No, I'll write it 10 times, 100 times, 1000 times. What? Never read speech, never read speech, never read speech. Reading the speech, it is not a speech. Reading the speech, you are not a speech. I will call it what? Because the audience is perhaps deaf or they have no eyesight, therefore we are reading into it. What do you do to a blind man? You read out to him. Okay. So therefore, if you are reading, then it is actually you are not, we are not actually giving a speech. We are sitting in front of a blind man. And somebody like me, if he's an audience who is a blind guy, who will say, oh dear, you are not a speaker. You are reading your speech. So reading the speech, I can do better than you. What is that we lose in reading the speech? One, the reader doesn't understand when has he reached the full stop. So he continues to talk in a rhythm fashion, no voice modulation. He doesn't know where to give the thrust. He doesn't know himself what he's talking about. So most probably, I would say any speaker, if he's reading the speech has been prepared by somebody. He had no time to look through that speech even before coming. Now that's horrible. Don't give such speeches. Statistics, what does it say? Statistics says 50% of the people slip if you read the speech. Now, I'm afraid the statistics is quite favorable because I was feeling that perhaps almost 100% people sleep if you read the speech. But then there are some audience who still don't sleep. Maybe because they will feel that they will get caught or they have been given a free pass to attend or the program itself is free and is followed by lunch or dinner. So you feel obliged and you cannot sleep. Or you feel that the speaker himself is my friend. So what can I do if I am not awake? Who can be awake? So therefore, it's a good news that only 50% people speak if you are reading the speech. We cannot be remembering sentences. So what we should go? Go for anecdotes. Go for examples. And then, do you remember any of the past speeches? Think of which is the point should be ready, but points are in the PowerPoint, Mr. Ashish Pandey. Points are the PowerPoints. Right? What is PowerPoint? PowerPoint is covering the points. Okay. So keeping points ready means what? Your speech should be in a PowerPoint, I would say. All right. And one picture speaks 1000 times more than words. So therefore, we should put maximum pictures. All right. Now, do you see the font type of these slides? It is quite a lot different than what we normally type. Cosmic. Why? Because you get a feeling that as if you're writing. Now, all of you, I request one thing. Very quickly write in the chat, in an actual speech you have heard from anybody and you remember something what he has said. Just keep typing. Let's say anybody's speech. You need not give the speaker's name. You can say, I was hearing the speech on this subject and I remember something about this. I remember this point. Modi speech, what do you remember? Nitin Brahma, please write. Corona full form. Okay, great. And Coke story. Who is this VP? PM speech, how to be safe. Okay. Bhai or Behno? All right. Michael sir, so you still remember? We road par na nikle. Okay, okay. Good, good, good. CM speech. All right. Tell me, what do you remember? All right. There are very, very few comments coming up. What does that mean? Other than PM, don't you have read, heard any speech in your life? Can we have the speech other than PM and CM? Okay, somebody is saying Rahul Singh, Gabbar Singh tax. Okay, good, good. Okay, Diksha, what is this? Is rules learn fast, fail fast, seen when fast? Whose speech it is? Good. All right, so now I've heard a lot, but I want other than politicians and film stars. Other than film stars and Asan hai, Sandeep Maheshwari, good. I like that. That is sir, what is prohibited is permitted. What is not prohibited is permitted. Okay, Sachin, whose is this? If you want to shine like a sun, first burn like a sun. Ah, okay. Mukeshji, you remember me at Surat. TED talk. I think Rupali, I need to chat with you on what is TED talk. Today morning only we were discussing about it. Ah, Raghu, you remember me at Coimbatore? Sachin is talking about trust is a must. Very good. So by now, all of you have got a lot of quotations. Very good. Okay. So remember those. Can you create such kind of anecdotes? Then, larger the audience, what should you do? You should go for poll. Okay. What is a poll? Take some voting on some subject. If you are doing a webinar particularly, then take some voting. Is there a voting available, my dear friend Raunak? Just tell me. And even otherwise, when you take a poll, you end up into getting the audience involved into that. So ask them the questions or say, how many of you believe that India will reach how many trillion? Trillion economy by 2020.
5 trillion.
Okay. Then, how many YouTube lectures we have watched? If not, we must watch many, many YouTube lectures. And we must find out who are the good speakers. And accordingly. Okay. So, after reading the various lectures on YouTube or browsing them, see how many sentences you can remember. For example, one of my how to pass CA has been put, into YouTube. You will find that it is so attractive. There I am saying that 199 is 0 and 200 is equal to 400. So many people recollect that dialogue. And Vipur, you are saying looking at present scenario, 5 trillion is looking easy for India. My God, you are making this statement on a Corona day, when people are afraid of unemployment and recession. All right. Now, above everything, can you speak from heart? When can you speak from heart? We can speak from the heart when content is known to us. We can speak from heart when really we are engrossed in trying to give something to audience. Now there the transparency matters a lot. Transparency matters a lot. Many times people come with the speech readiness saying that I need this audience to be captured in order to make them my clients. Then what happens? Many consultants come like that. And they restrict it up to a certain stage. And they don't know where to stop and where to continue. Because they don't want to give everything. Because if they give everything away, they feel that the knowledge shared means nobody will come to consult me. So that's a very important thing. So therefore, if we get such a kind of feeling, then we met many types of such consultants. And then they want to give you half a knowledge, a test of knowledge. Why? Because they have come to build the brand and they want to become popular and they want to make you their clients. Whenever somebody has that in mind, obviously one will withhold it. But seriously, suppose you want to give a speech and you want to make somebody to connect him as a client at a later date. Say it so openly. Look, I am giving this speech to you because I want you to become great speakers. For example, the purpose of this free webinar was, I want you to become a great speaker, but whenever you will go for a great speech, and that time somebody says, oh my God, sir, you have given a great speech to you. That time do say that Mr. RamMohan Bhave taught me how to give a good speech, right? So here are few pictures which you should put. Now these pictures have no relevance. Okay, but can you create some such pictures and put it? So, which are the most valued internet companies? And why they become most valued? Because their pitch or their speech to the audience is great. Okay. Or can you create some graphs, colorful graphs, which can be great? And then, can you see what is Walmart versus Amazon? Then, crouching tiger coming in, Ambanis, coming into the e-commerce. So can you create some such kind of picture? They're nowadays easily available, the smart art and all that. So, to move forward and come near to the end of my speech, have a courage to follow your heart and intuition. So don't bother. Steve Jobs is one of my idol, and I see that whenever I want to speak, I really remember and say that I will take it upfront, take the bull by its horn, and then speak openly. So for example, sometimes you may not make the organizers very happy, or sometimes you may end up into everybody being, you know, sort of not so very pleased. But humor can overcome that and can help you. And if you are speaking from your heart, your heart touches the heart of the other man, whatever the least important that subject is, I will tell you something. One of the best thing, do you know why I could become a good speaker? Simple reason. Why? Because I'm a husband. At home, I don't get chance to talk. So what happens? I go out and keep speaking. And that's why every year I give at least 200 lectures. So those who are not married yet, please get married, then you will become great speaker. You know why? Because in the home, you won't get a chance to speak. Now I am, due to Corona, I am out of action, so online lectures. Now online lectures, do you dare to say this? The best way is close the door. Because my wife is sleeping inside. That's why I kept it at 3 to 4 after keeping the time, what time she sleeps. And I'm saying all these lectures, okay, I'm saying this in all the lectures that I cannot get a chance to speak at home. Therefore, I speak outside, but make this joke every time to the new audience. So every time, if you do the same joke to the same audience, every time that won't work. So all ladies, can they become good speaker or not? Of course. All ladies don't have to say that they have to become good speaker. They are born good speakers. In fact, I know that somebody like Divya, who gives the lectures to the board of directors, is in the audience thanks to her. Okay. So they are both speakers, and I know Divya, how great speaker she is. So with this, I conclude my today's chat with you. And if you have anything more to learn, I'm sure we'll be in touch. Here is RamMohan Bhave. You have my email ID and my phone number. And anytime, feel free, have a chat, ask how to become a great speaker. If you want to give a speech, we always have a platform available for you. Thank you. Don't go for books. Just get into giving speeches.
Thank you so much, Bhave sir. It was really insightful. And
anybody is not getting audience to hear, please meet me. Please call me. I will arrange your lecture. We have a CP study circle of chartered accountants where we arrange many lectures.
In Navi Mumbai CS chapter also, we are looking for speakers. So if anybody wants to speak on any topic related to the valuations, the company law, they're most welcome. IPR. Thank you.